Hello, everybody. My name is Jan. I'm the creative director at Artifice Studio, and I'm very excited to tell you more about our upcoming and most ambitious game to date, Legends of the Round Table. Legends of the Round Table plunges you into the heart of Arthurian folklore, blending narrative and strategy in a unique RPG inspired by authentic medieval tales told with hand-drawn illustrated manuscripts and music played on real medieval instruments. In the game, you manage King Arthur's Round Table and guide your knights through exciting quests full of challenges, combat, intrigue, and of course, romance. Every quest has its own challenges and every knight has different traits, so choosing the right knights is crucial. Some are better at courtesy, others are great fighters, and others are so rich they can just throw money at the problem.
Down falls the creature, there it lies. The bugle sounds to claim the prize. The bugle sounds to claim the prize.
We wrote a ton of songs and animated beautiful cinematics for the beginning of every adventure, and some peppered throughout too. In this first adventure, one of our knights is kidnapped by a giant named Grommer. And since the adventures are non-linear, they can be approached in multiple ways. So, to get to our lost friend, we need to go through mercenary knights blocking a bridge. We could fight them, try to talk it out, or find another way. When trying to achieve things, you'll sometimes trigger challenges. For example, persuading someone to reveal secrets, investigating magical fey tracks, or taming a wild horse. Every challenge has a difficulty number you want to match or exceed to succeed the challenge. Depending on who or what you're challenging, the difficulty number can be visible or not. You try to meet that difficulty number by adding your knight's relevant traits and by playing cards from your hand. Just like in medieval stories, magic exists in Legends of the Round Table. Spells can be learned through various encounters. There's a huge variety of them. Some really shine in combat, others can cleanse your knights from curses, some let you manipulate your deck, and so on. Combat is a rich simulation that offers you a ton of different options every turn. We have a video planned just for talking about combat, but for now, here's a quick sneak peek. It's turn-based and movement is hex-based. There's, of course, big emphasis on horses, charging, various saddles, barding, lances, and so on. Your knight's horse has stats of its own. When attacking or defending from an attack, a challenge comes into play. Since your opponent is a living being, the difficulty number is the score they play. Like all challenges, you must match or exceed the difficulty score through your knight's traits and by playing cards. Mercy is another important aspect of combat. Sparing a surrendering knight's life is often a good move. You get a ransom, gain honor, and don't have to fight any longer. Combat is really meant to be meaningful. Every fight helps progress the story. Like I said earlier, there's a ton of options and actions you can take in combat. Simulations based on your horse, weapons, stats, equipment, and even morale. We'll dive deeper into it in the coming months. All right, there's still so much more we could talk about. Knights growing old, the great mass battles that happen every few years, solo quests, all the other adventures we have planned, but we can't spoil everything. What are you most excited to learn about? Let us know in the comments below. Oh, and feel free to join our Discord server and nerd over medieval stuff with us. Your excitement really fuels our motivation, and we hope you'll join us on this incredible adventure of bringing medieval art and folklore into the form of a game for everyone to enjoy. That's all for today, but I'll see you in the next video.